Now we have Ban Ki-moon. He even have Moon in his name. He still have not been able to bring peace.
Yeah.
Who is the Prince of Peace? Tell us something.
The Prince of Peace is Jesus Christ.
Oh, hallelujah.
That's what Isaiah prophesied That's about right. him. He said what? He's going to be what? A counselor. A Prince of Peace. Nobody can advise you on this planet except Jesus Christ.
Because he is the Prince of
Hallelujah.
Peace.
Hallelujah. Nobody can change your destiny except for Jesus Christ. And this Christmas, this moment is a time of his birth. You know, when you think about even how he was born, this man was born in what? In a manger.
In a manger.
In a place where animals sleep.
Who?
But we are born in a beautiful hospitals. He came low so that we can come high.
That's it. That's the word. Pastor, you've just said it all. You've just said it all. The man came low that we will be high.
Hallelujah.
He came, left all his riches in heaven, and took on a form of a servant.
Yep.
Today, if you have not given your life to Christ, we want to invite you and give you that privilege to give your life to Christ.
Amen.
Because you see, he came that we might have peace. He came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. What are you waiting for? It is not about the food that you will eat today. It's not about the drinks. Because you see, the power of the kingdom is not about food and drink. Bible says in John 3:16 that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So it's out of love. The gifts that you see us give at Christmas just stands for the gift that was given to us, Christ the Lord. Today, if you have not accepted him, make it a point. We want to make your Christmas a special one. Today is a special day. Every believer in Christ cannot ignore this day, because this is the day that changed history forever.
Amen.
Apart from his birth, there had not been any virgin without the sperm donor of a man that has been able to give birth. It has never happened, and it will never happen. He is the Alpha and the Omega. You know, when you go to the book of John, he says he was with God from the very beginning.
Hallelujah.
And there was nothing that was made without him.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to take a spot of music.
Amen.
And I chose this music specially because I went all the way back. And I know this music will excite you, but you see, today is a special day. I am full of joy. I don't know about you, Pastor.
I'm full. I'm so happy to be here today.
Oh, praise the name of the living God.
Because, you know, people don't get me. Where I was, and now where I am.
Oh,
I'm happy.
You see, the change is great.
Come on.
Nobody meets the Lord, Pastor, and remains the same. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
They don't know what we got. Sometimes we go crazy about Jesus.
That's right.
Because I was out there doing my own thing.
Mm.
But he called me.
Mm.
He said, well, and I'll call you by your name.
That's right.
So he called me by my name. And if this is we are remembering his birth.
Yeah.
I have to be happy.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Listen, somebody watching right now, we are going to take a special Christmas song. And I dedicate this song to all our viewers. And especially to my producer, Kenny. Because, you know, he's a very special man. Kenny, this is for you and for all the people that are out with us. And especially the family of New Life Christian Love Fellowship. Enjoy this music. We'll be right back.
This boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Boy, word was a glow. All the bells rang out, there were tears of joy and laughter. People shout and let everyone know there is hope for all to find peace.
Now Joseph and his wife Mary came to Bethlehem that night.
They found no place to bear her child.
Hallelujah. Oh, praise the name of the living God. I've been dancing here because man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day, because the King was born. And we are so excited again. I wish you a Merry Christmas. Now, come with me, somebody. Let me tell you something. We meet every Wednesday, and I'm going to give you the address. You will see the address. Wednesdays. A time that you can join us. You know, the address to our fellowship hall is 648 Bay Street, 648 Bay Street here in Staten Island. And we meet every Wednesday for Bible studies. That is at 7 p.m. And then Fridays is a prayer night, 7 p.m. And then Sundays are the days that we meet for our Sunday worship. So I want to invite you this Sunday, come and be part of the great movement that God is doing, even as this year is coming to an end and your life will never be the same. I have been blessed today. And, you know, I am happy that we are able to come to you and bring you the word of God so that you understand that we celebrate Christmas, not happy holiday. It is not a holiday. Mm-hmm. It is Christmas because the King is born. And on this day, see, people say that, Pastor, why do you celebrate Christmas and not what Christ said in the Bible to be celebrated on Easter? You see, without the birth, there won't have been a death.
Yes.
So if you can celebrate the death, then remember, because everybody celebrates their birthday. I know my birthday. Pastor has his birthday.
Yeah.
But, you know, we celebrate the birth of he who died for us.
Amen.
You see, the scriptures that we read, he says, today a Savior is born in the city of David.
David, yep.
That's it. So today we came to present that Savior to you. That is why I'm saying that if you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, then make that decision today, because tomorrow may be too late. Pastor Desmond, what have you got to say as our time is coming up?
I want to say this, Colossians 1, verse 14.
Yeah.
The Bible says, in whom we have redemption through his blood, through the forgiving of sin. Who is the image of invisible God, the firstborn of every creature.
Amen, amen.
The firstborn.
That's it. So nobody can dispute the fact that we have a firstborn. I mean, come on, somebody.
And one thing that people don't understand, he was even there
before
when things were created.
And Bible says that everything that was made through him. Through him. Nothing.
Because when you read Genesis 1 verse 3, he said, well, and God said, let there be light. And there was light.
That's it.
Jesus is the light of this world.
That's a whole new topic.
Because in chapter 2 is what? The place was darkened. But when the light came, overshadowed the darkness, and all things were created through him.
Amen.
And all things were new. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Listen, I want to pray for somebody before we go. Our time, it's getting to an end, and I just want to pray for somebody. If you have not made that decision, make it a point on Christmas Day to give your life to God. Mm-hmm. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, once again, we come to you in the name of Jesus. And we ask that your grace will continue to be upon our lives. Father, you gave us the Prince of Peace. And the angel announced to all men on earth, peace, good tidings towards everybody. This is the word that we have brought today on Christmas Day. Somebody who is watching this program and has a decision to make today, Father, we pray that you will bring that person to the saving knowledge of Christ Jesus. Amen. My Lord and my God, it is our sincere desire that, Lord, as your servants have come and brought this message, somebody's life
is going to change.
It's going to change for the better in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
There is somebody out there who is going through certain struggles. There's somebody out there who thinks that there is no hope. But we've brought word of hope. That if only you accept him as your Lord and personal Savior, everything will work together for your good.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and grant you the grace until such a time that he will come again. In Jesus' name have we prayed with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
Pastor, I want to thank you so very
much
for coming to bless us today. And I believe that this is not going to be the end. We will see you again very soon.
Amen.
And you out there, you have been wonderful, as you always do. So we are not going to just leave you, but we leave you in the capable hands of the living God. That the Lord will continue to protect you in Jesus' name. Stay blessed. No stress. And you know my name, I'm out like that.
Amen.
Amen.
God's peace.